spot in my banana. Sweet. Smells like plastic. Oh, well. I don't have the salute. I wish I did. What's up, everyone? We're just winding down a very long, hot day here in East Bay, California. I am, of course, Scar the Samurai, your Saber host with the most, the great Sage himself. We're hanging out here with Hawk, with Ryan, with Lando. I want to say thank you so much for Bat and other people for tuning into the show today. Just another great day. We managed to get Lando's exotic sword bounty done. We managed to get the Nightfalls. We managed to grind. We can go do some more. Well, you know what? I probably don't have the time to really commit to too many more strikes tonight, to be honest. And we also got the sleeper stimulant. I'm going to call it the sleep aid, because it just puts you down for a long nap. We got that done today. So, boys and girls, if you log on and you see a mission on Earth, level 41, go do it. It starts the sleeper simulant quest line. I don't know when it comes, if there's a next stage, but I finished it with the help of Angel and Lando. Angel didn't finish his. Unfortunately, he got lost and went off and missed a Warsat, and then he couldn't do the 4-minute solo thing, so he missed out on the archive mission too. You do have to speed run a certain quest. You got 4 minutes. It's quite fun. Only reason I had to do it more than once is I didn't notice the time limit the first time. I was just fucking around. Motherfucker. Alright, so now we're on the daily heroic here. Yeah, it's doing that. This is a great song, folks. Taboo. Now you can find this on several soundtracks, including Strange Days and Natural Born Killers. Is this where we're going? Down here? Or is it this way? Alright, it's this way. Oh, I know. I was just looking around. My GPS was telling me to come up here first, so I wanted to make sure. I didn't think it was back that way. Also, folks, you know, I'm pretty big now. I've had the full time. We hope you tune in tomorrow as we set up for the raid this weekend. We're basically, you know, it's our first time doing the raid. Last week we had a great run, but unfortunately schedules were really amiss, and we all couldn't finish it. But normally it's also, Saturday's my last day of the week. So Sunday and Monday, where most people can polish off their Destiny game, I'm not playing. And that's why it's always been kind of an issue. Now, during the summer, of course, for any students that play with me, not an issue. But the school year is in session. So Monday through Friday, we have a lot of things like that. You know, and if we can get it done this weekend, great. But the weekend after that, I have a whole weekend to do it. I'm doing mega shows. So we'll get it done then for sure. Why is that thing invisible? Oh, it's a fake. So I just got Monte Carlo Year 2. For a lot of people, I never could get any of the PlayStation exclusives Year 1. And it was kind of like this joke. Like, I just can't seem to get them. I got every other exotic except for the PlayStation's exclusives and the Vex Mythicals. Deep into the heart of the planet. Which is one reason why I want to go do the Vault of Glass. I heard two rumors. One, if you go in at level 41 with a light of 275 or higher, you're guaranteed to Vex Mythocast if you don't have it in your blueprints. Don't know if that's true. Want to Mythbust it. That's why I want to do it. I want to Mythbust if that's true. I'd never have found the Vex Mythocast. I'm higher than 275. Why not put that to a myth? Second, I never got Hawkmoon. I still haven't got the Fourth Horseman Year 1 or 2. But that limbo, oh look, purple ammo up there. If I only had my gun with shoot the loot on it, I'll get up there and get it. No problem. Keep you covered, Hawk. No, it's fine. It's all good. I don't care. I never got Hawkmoon, Monte Carlo, or the Fourth Horseman. Now that week of limbo, and then the first week that it came on, and we all got that green engram to open up. It became Monte Carlo. I can't remember if it was a year one or a year two now. It's still in my vault. It could be a year two, but I don't think it was. It was a year one. And then today I just got the year two. I bought Hawkmoon from Zerf. And, of course, I've found, like, four since. But I still haven't got the fourth horseman. That's actually the only exotic I'm going for. It was year one? I thought it was. I would have been using it. It would have been in my inventory. Now, I don't know. I think my Titan will probably end up getting this gun and Jade Rabbit. I'm not going to duplicate every gun. I like to give my characters a little different personality through their weapons. With the new armor ability, also, you can reach 310 with any combo of colored armor if you grind it right. Then... Cartana, I am not talking to you. I'm a fucking cunt of a program. So anyways, I'm excited about that. I kind of got deterred there while stumbling on. We were talking about the raids. Friday and Saturday, you know, the raids. I was hoping to do, like, a checkpoint Tuesday evening for, like, an hour or two with people. Checkpoint Wednesday, an hour or two with people. Checkpoint Thursday. Friday, get to Golgoth and maybe beat him, and then,
Remember,
and then, you know, Saturday, work on Oryx, and then just party in the Crucible with our gear. It's all about scheduling right now, folks, because we've got players on the West Coast, Midwest, East Coast, Europe, you know, all across the board, Canada. Time zones are all over the place, but I will get up this Saturday way early, like 4:20 in the morning my time, and be on the air at like 5:45, and we can get the raid started a lot earlier. Last week we got started on the raid almost 1 p.m. and then, you know, that's 3 o'clock, 5 o'clock, and so on across our raiders, and it just got too late. A lot of them had to go, so, you know, we're gonna work on that. Also, unfortunately, it's a fact now, we just have too many regulars that play Destiny, but we have enough for 2 6-person teams. Ah! Oh my god, triple jump saved my life.
Guardian down.
I'm coming back for you. We got room for one more, folks. Bubs is on vacation that weekend. Godkiller wasn't home. Hawk wasn't on the game yet and was just getting on it. So, you know, now we've got, like, 3 more players in the game. The fact is, we have another 5 or 6 regular Dragons of the Black. Yeah, you know, and it might be, like, one of those tag teams, you know. Somebody has to leave. Last time on Saturday, Angel fell asleep. Bat ended up just kind of going AFK and had to deal with shit. Crow was really late for him, and he didn't want to play anymore, and he wanted to kind of quiet to sleep. So me, Fear, and Lando just went off and did shit, which was fun. And profitable. So it's, you know, it's never been getting along, finding the strength, doing the raid. It's just scheduling. That's my big problem. I don't know if any of my followers, other than one, that are on the East Coast, or sorry, West Coast, here in California. So everyone that watches me and plays with me is at least 3 hours ahead. Only GameMan745, one of our geekly gaming streamers, who's been on hiatus for quite some time, but he's coming back strong with better gaming. He was here in California, down south, so we were the only ones ever in the same time zone. Big issue. Yeah, it's 7:35. See, it's like 4:35 here. Like I said, everyone pretty much is 3 hours ahead, and then like Pro is 6 hours. A couple of my regs that play GTA with us are 12 hours ahead. Alright, so I'm going to let Hawk go up to the spot. I'm going to go to my sweet spot right here. This is where I hang out and do any battle here I see. Once you queue up something, you can just come back here and hang. I'm not sure if it'll work for this one. Also, there's several ghosts up here. So if you guys don't have them, it's good to come during... God damn it, this gun does not have the range for us. Alright, never mind. I'd have to go scout or pulse for this to work. I bound. Shit, no, maybe not. Oh shit, I thought that was it. Oh yeah, we gotta fight the Alpha. This guy you can fight from back here. And I'm, the only reason I say it's good sometimes is if, you know, so you have a route. Those hobgoblins, the respawn times. Just like that. But I've done this with Skolos. I don't know if I can hang out here safely with this dude. Not this isn't the spot. It's actually over here. I don't have a sniper out, but I can switch it on. Just want to make sure nothing spawns over here. As soon as you're back. Alright, I'm going to go into my menu. I got a really good explosive round sniper rifle. I'm going to switch over to my baloney for long range right now. I can't. Yeah, this was a great dead orbit score. The roll on it was explosive rounds. Oh shit, something hit. I love the sound. Grasp of the key. Oh, he just drove away. Damn.
Guardian down.
Ah! What the fuck? That shit just flew around the corner and hit me in the face. Yeah. Take my light, motherfucker. I don't care. Alright. Hobgoblin going down. Goblin down. Shit, what the fuck's hitting me? Oh, that dude. Oh, I see. There's a little ledge back here. I'm like, what the fuck's making me tall enough to shoot this guy? And then all of a sudden, I'm not. I thought my controller was dying. I'm like, why the fuck is it not? God damn it. Incoming. He's down. Armor boost, bitch. God damn it, one bullet. Whoa, massive incoming. Oh, you have the same sniper. Dead orbit, baby. I guess I should have got fucking rocket launcher. Good? Whew!
You sent Oryx screaming.
Yeah, check out the roll I got on this sniper rifle. And one of those things, people, too, it's always good to know each other's favorite weapons and what they have and what they do, you know. It makes for better combatants if you know who uses what and what they have. It also makes for a better soldier if you communicate it, but also kind of keep the same combo. No one's going to memorize who changed the guns up.